as a result of the implementation of both NRC and CAA, the persons who will be directly affected will be the Muslims of India. All other religious groups, even if excluded under NRC, will be included under CAA. Only the Muslims will be identified as illegal migrants under NRC and excluded under CAA. Naturally, there is widespread fear and uncertainty among the Muslims of India. Now they've raised a new bogey, the NPR bogey, and said UPA did it in 2010. Let's get the facts right. The widespread protests have forced the government to backtrack on what the Home Minister and other ministers had said in Parliament on many occasions, most recently on December 9 in the Lok Sabha and December 11 in the Rajya Sabha. The government has therefore come up with the idea of NPR and has attempted to liken it with a census-related exercise undertaken in 2010. There is a world of difference between NPR 2010 and NPR 2020. Let me repeat this. There is a world of difference between NPR 2010 and NPR 2020. It's like chalk and cheese. NPR 2010 was conducted in a few states when there was no controversy about NRC and without the unhappy experience of the Assam NRC. Secondly, there was no CAA at that time. Thirdly, NPR 2010 gathered data in respect of only 15 fields. Let me repeat, 15 fields. On the contrary, NPR 2020 will be conducted all over the country. It will be done in the background of the disastrous experience of Assam NRC and the discriminatory CAA. And the form that will be used in NPR 2020 will have many additional fields. For example, they will ask you, what is your last place of residence? What is the place of birth of your parents? What is your voter identity number? What is your passport number? What is your driver's license? What is your PAN? And what is your Aadhaar? Now I want to ask, who added these fields? And why were they added? In terms of text and context, NPR 2010 and NPR 2020 are very different. NPR 2020, with the additional fields, is a disguised attempt to do an Assam-like NRC throughout the country, and therefore it must be stoutly opposed. The NRC-CAA-NPR exercise is part of the RSS-BJP plan to push its divisive agenda for Hindu Rashtra. The Constitution of India embodies values of equality, secularism, humanism, and constitutional morality. In order to protect those values, every patriotic Indian has a duty to fight the pernicious doctrine of Hindu Rashtra. That is why thousands of people, especially students and young men and women, are on the streets to save the idea of India and save the constitution given to us by Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, and Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Abraham Lincoln saved the Constitution of the United States in 1865. Our task and our duty are not different. While the fire lit by the hurried passage of CAA rages across the country, the economy continues to sink. There has not been a single silver lining in the last 6 months. Year on year, imports are down 8.37%. Exports are down 2.21%. Direct tax revenue collections are only 41.6% of the budget estimate. Credit growth to industry is a paltry 3.4%. Manufacturing output has shrunk 3.8%. The fiscal deficit will breach the budget limit of 3.4%. Wholesale price index inflation is at 1.92% and CPI is at 5.54%. Food inflation has crossed 10%. As warned, they didn't listen to our warning. The cut in corporate tax rates did not boost investment. Private consumption has declined significantly. the government has run out of money to spend or invest in the last quarter of 2019-20. It is obvious the government is clueless and seems to think that ignorance is bliss. So we shall stop here and take questions on CAA and the economy if you wish. Yes. I think that question should be put to the chief ministers. As of now, our position is we oppose the CAA and we oppose the NPR exercise. Now, when is the NPR exercise going to start? As far as the government of India is concerned, I don't know. Let them first indicate that an NPR exercise has to start. I don't think there is any directive so far from the central government to any state government. I may be wrong, but I don't think any instruction has gone from the Home Ministry to any state government. You must start the NPR.